Thank you so much, Sunam Dai, for being here with us in this platform. It is an honor to be seated next to you and have this gathering of the dignitaries and personalities of Nepal. हामीले उहाँको नेपाली सुन्यौँ अब हामी नेपालको एउटा अर्को भाषाबाट यो क्वेसन एन्सरको सुरुवात गर्नेछौँ अहाँकेँ केहन लागि रहल अछि सुनम दाई
हाम्रो बड़ निक लागि रहल
ग्रेट सो द्याट वाज मैथिली विच इज स्पोकन इन द तराई बेल्ट अफ नेपाल एन्ड द रिजन वी स्टार्टेड दिस वे इज ल्याङ्ग्वेज इज अल्सो स्किल learning as much as about 9 languages. Sunam Dai, right from the airport, we have started speaking in either Maithili or Nepali or talking in English.
Maithili, I'm just playing.
He understands it very well. And then Hindi, and Mr. Abhishek from Indian Embassy and Sunam Dai also converse in French. So all these are also skills. So just to start with, Dai, what is it which is not true in Three Idiots?
You would rather ask what is true.
What is true? Okay. So what is true then?
Very little. I think it's made too much out of. It's just a, inspiration. It's not a biopic historical documentation at all. It's just some inspiration with lots of masala as it happens. So what I like is the making people think about what education should be and what it should not be. That's the spirit that I would agree with more than details of it.
Right. So it's not everything in Three Idiots that is not true. So let us remember that. So Sunam Dai, स्किल हजुरको विभिन्न प्रोफेसन्सहरूमा हजुरले बस्नु भएको छ इभन यु हेभ जन जर्नलिजम अरू अरू चिज पनि गर्नुभएको छ वेन इट वाज द फर्स्ट टाइम वेन यु थट स्किल इज इम्पोर्टेन्ट हाउ डिड इट केम
मैले त्यसरी हेरेको छैन मैले जहाँ जो जरुरत पर्यो वाट एभर इट टेक्स भन्छौँ नि यु डु वाट एभर इट टेक्स टु गेट द थिङ डन सो वेन आई निडेड टु move, I learned driving. When I needed to raise awareness, we started a magazine, we started a radio channel, we started a CD channel, when internet was not there, we started posting video magazines where people were not literate enough to read. When it took training of teachers, I went and learned how to train teachers and started training teachers. When it took a building that would not be freezing cold in Ladakhi winters, I had the engineering skill or education, but then learned how to handle Mato, and which was the most, as I said, abundant available resource, like earth under our feet and sun over our head. It made sense. You didn't have to, think a lot. Something that is as abundant as sunshine, it would be surprising not to use it, and something that is as abundant as earth. So I didn't think of it as a skill. It may fall under that now, but we did whatever it took.
So
how we should be guided.
So
in life.
Seems very well that it's instilled. So skill is instilled in everybody.
Yes.
And it is just about recognizing it as time goes.
Exactly. I find it very difficult to this compartmentalized, partitioned society where you are just a doctor, you're just an engineer, you're just an artist. We are everything in us. It should be cross-disciplinary, interdisciplinary.
Right.
We are all a holistic mix of so many things. Why would you impoverish yourself rather than enrich yourself with more such abilities?
That is very right. And that is all about what we say is, skill can be anything. It is not exactly this or that. It can be anything at all. And that is why we are celebrating this Skill Week and focusing on Sip Le Samman, Sip Ko Samman. So we need to respect skill and respect would get us, skill would get us respect as well. So without taking much of your time, if there is anybody, we're ready to take about 2 to 3 questions from anybody of you. If there is anyone who wants to ask something to Sunam Dai, then you are more than welcome. Charubam. Can we have a mic, please?
Good evening, Mr. Sonam Wangchuk. It's a pleasure to have you in Nepal. My question to you would be, for the youth of today, what would be one skill beyond the basics that you think is a life skill that every youth must possess?
I don't know if it could be called a skill, but being self-confident and not always, trying to find somebody to copy, thinking on your own feet and for your own needs and doing whatever it takes and learning to learn, I would say. The skill of learning whatever is needed would be a skill to have, I would say.
Any more?
I'd like to see some.
Yeah, please. Mike, please. Yeah.
Thank you. I'd rather sit down. Thank you very much, Mr. Sonam, for your presence today. Your presence today and being here also proves something, one thing, that nothing is really ever impossible, or anything is possible. You're someone we know from a movie in India, and you're here today. That's a wonderful thing. And so you talk about education and skills, putting them together, and how our children should be brought up with skills in their part of education so that they can be diverse and not into only one path. I was wondering if you have also come across or doing something over education where it's not only about skills and academics, where education is also seen as something what children learn at their homes with their parents, in the community with their relatives, and throughout the country with media or any kind of exposure. So how do you see that whole thing? Because education, it's not something you go to an institution and get certificate. It's everything that you're learning based on what you're hearing, seeing, feeling, experiencing. How do you see that? What would you tell me more that I can learn from?
Thank you.
Thank you.
I think learning is always that. It's only a matter of what we measure in these examinations that makes us think that this is learning, this is not, this is learning, this is not. But we learn from everything and everybody, and as some people in Africa say, it takes a whole village to bring up a child. So yes, we are always learning, and we should honor it as that, and not just the classroom with the chalk and talk as learning. And therefore, our examination system should be more enlightened, more evolved than just testing them on some set questions that you, again, have a ritualized way of answering. So it is always that. It's just a matter of recognizing what learning is.
Thank you. Thank you. Any more? Okay. We'll have that last question.
Hello. Thank you for coming to Nepal and sharing your stories. Going back to Three Idiots once again.
I think we are overdoing that part.
Just to connect that with the skills, there are pranks that has come up which has tackled bullies that happens in colleges and also in schools. So what is one instant, or what is one instant which is true and something that young people could really learn from? A vivid example which is portrayed in Three Idiots that you could narrate which was true from your life.
I don't know we need to relate to a movie, but generally I would say just thinking, not limited by the boxes and the circles and the squares, but thinking organically and thinking literally, unusually and organically is a skill that we would like you know, our world to have more of for our children, and letting children follow their own passion rather than again the trodden paths that society thinks you should, is what I would say, without having to refer to a film.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Sonam Dai. Thank you, everyone, for having your questions. And so now, as we end this keynote speech and the question and answer session, I would now like to take this moment to honor Mr. Wangchuk, which is a very big thing for us. There are a few of our mentors, and he is the mentor of those mentors. So it is a very big honor for us to honor him. And for that, I would like to request Mr. Anil Kesarisa, Mr. Abhishek Upadhyay, and my colleagues Kajol, Sushila, Ajay, to join me in honoring Mr. Wangchuk.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you for being here with us.
Thank you. Thank you. Dhanyawad. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
So it's the Certificate of Honor, Global Private Limited honors Mr. Sonam Wangchuk, engineer turned education reformer, founder president of the board, SECMOL, for his contribution in reforming education system to make it real and practical and promoting skills. Thank you so much, Mr. Wangchuk, for
being here. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Certifying Thank you. My skills.
That is not certification. That is just a small honor for you.
Thank you.
Yes, we have a group photo.